हेलो एवरीबॉडी, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड स्टोरी नंबर 4 फ्रॉम सप्लीमेंट्री रीडर एंड टुडेज चैप्टर नेम इज द ओल्ड क्लॉक शॉप। दिस स्टोरी इज अबाउट अ पर्सन हु हैज क्लॉक शॉप इन द प्लेस कॉल्ड साल्ट लेक सिटी इन द USA एंड हिज नेम वॉज रे हु वॉज ओल्ड एंड डेफ। दिस स्टोरी शोज अस द काइंडनेस ऑफ रे टूवर्ड्स अ स्ट्रेंजर ऑन क्रिसमस ईव। लेट अस रीड द स्टोरी। क्रिसमस ईव हैड अराइव्ड एंड लास्ट मिनट शॉपर्स वेर गोइंग होम। अ थिक व्हाइट शीट ऑफ स्नो ले ओवर साल्ट लेक सिटी USA, येट द लाइट्स वर स्टिल बर्निंग इन द ओल्ड क्लॉक शॉप एज रे इट्स ओल्ड डेफ ओनर वर्कड ऑन अ क्लॉक ही हैड सोल्ड दैट डे। Christmas Eve had arrived. Christmas Eve, Eve means evening, and also Christmas Eve means the night before the Christmas day, had arrived. As last minute shoppers were going home, having completed shopping, shoppers were going home, about to go. A thick white sheet of snow lay over Salt Lake City. And the place name was Salt Lake City in the USA. Yet the lights were still burning, or we can say, yet the lights were still on in the old clock shop. And in that shop, there was a man, and his name was Ray. As Ray, its old deaf owner, worked on a clock he had sold that day. And why he was late? Why he didn't close yet his shop? Because of he had some work. He had worked on a clock which he had to sell on that day. Let us move ahead to next para. Having finished his work, Ray stood up and was on his way to the back room when a cold rush of air from the front door hit the back of his neck. It means someone opened the door. As he was deaf, he was unable to hear. He couldn't hear the sound of the opening of the door, but he felt that someone opened the door. He turned to meet a last minute shopper, but his old wise eyes told him that this was not a shopper. This was not a buyer. He saw two men, one in his 20s, the other closer to 50. One is in his 20s, means between 20 to 29 years of age. The other closer to 50, about to 50. The younger man remained at the door. The older man approached the counter, reached the counter with no sign of friendliness in his eyes. Ray was able to hide his growing fear as he slowly pushed a notepad and a pencil across the counter. Ray was able to hide. Ray was able to control his growing fear as he slowly pushed a notepad and a pencil across the counter. As Ray was deaf, he used to give notepad and pencil or pen to the customers to write on it what they want. He smiled at the unfriendly face, then pointed to his ears and shook his head from side to side. He means Ray. Ray smiled at the unfriendly face, then pointed to his ears and shook his head from side to side. Means he wanted to tell him, he tried to tell him that I am deaf. I am unable to hear. A quick look of surprise changed the man's face as he studied the notepad. Then he turned and said something to his friend, who was remained at the door. Ray used the chance to look closely at the man, paying attention to the shape of a gun and a restless hand in the man's right coat pocket. Ray used the chance. Which chance? When the man turned and talked with his friend who was remained at the door. Ray used this chance and looked him closely. And Ray noticed that, saw that there was a gun in the man's right coat pocket and his hand was restless, means ही वॉज रेडी टू टेक आउट द गन. एंगर बॉइल्ड विद हिम, हिम मीन्स हियर रे, बट इट वॉज केप्ट डाउन बाय एन इनर वॉइस दैट सेड बी स्टिल. मीन्स ही हिमसेल्फ, रे हिमसेल्फ मैनेज्ड हिम. बी स्टिल मीन्स काम डाउन, कीप क्वाइट. ही हिमसेल्फ कंट्रोल्ड. ही रोट ऑन द नोट पैड, मे आई हेल्प यू. फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम द ओल्डन मैन लुक्ड डिरेक्टली एट रे एंड स्माइल्ड, अ क्रूल मॉकिंग स्माइल, आर्टिफिशियल स्माइल. देर वॉज आर्टिफिशियल स्माइल. दे बोथ अंडरस्टूड वाई ही वॉज देर, वाई हिज फ्रेंड रिमेन एट द डोर. दे बोथ मीन्स रे एंड द ओल्डर मैन, दे बोथ अंडरस्टूड वाई ही वॉज देर, वाई ही वॉज इन द शॉप, वाई दे वेर इन द शॉप, वाई हिज फ्रेंड रिमेन एट द डोर. एक्चुअली दे बोथ वेर रॉबर्स, दे वॉन्टेड टू रॉब, दे वॉन्टेड टू लूट द शॉप. And why the younger man remained at the door? Because of he wanted to keep an eye on police or other customers. That's why he remained at the door. They looked like men who were down on their luck. How they looked? Like men who were down on their time, bad time. And were now ready to try something they would later be sorry about. That's why now they were ready to try something to get money they would later be. The clocks ticked on. Ray calmly wrote another message. Have you come to pick up a clock or watch? The clocks ticked on, means the clocks were running. Tick, tick, tick. Ray calmly wrote another message, second message. Have you come to pick up to buy a clock or watch? Then he pointed to the lone board filled with hanging clocks and pocket watches. Apart from that, Ray offered him one more option. Then he pointed to the lone board. What was another option? Then he pointed to the lone board, which was filled with hanging clocks and pocket watches. He was not a pawnbroker, but at the same time couldn't say no to the needy people who placed their old watches or clocks before him for anything they could get. He was not a pawnbroker. Pawnbroker means a person who lends money at interest. Already I have written here, a person who lends money at interest. Though he was not a pawnbroker, but at the same time he couldn't say no to the poor needy people. He loaned more than he should. They would be there when the owners wanted them back. They would be there. They means here clocks, watches. Would be there when the owners wanted them back. At the same price he had paid, with no interest. Without interest. Without interest, Ray used to give them money. Then the older man seemed to feel a little easier, took out his hand from his pocket and quickly looked at the watch on his wrist. How much will you give me for this? The man wrote. Means what is mentioned here? After listening loan word, after seeing loan boat, the man, the older man thought that without robbing, without stealing also, we may get money. That's why the older man felt little easier. That's why he took out his hand from his pocket and quickly looked at the watch on his wrist. How much? And he asked to Ray, how much will you give me for this? The man wrote. Ray noticed a little shame in the gray eyes looking at him. Ray noticed that there was a shame in his eyes. Whose eyes? Older man's eyes. The watch was nothing special and yet had great powers. Although the watch was nothing special but had great powers, means can be exchanged on loan. It was something to exchange, a way out of a bad situation. Knowing that great need had brought the man to his shop, Ray realized that Ray felt that great need had brought the man to his shop. In the first place, Ray asked, "How much do you need for it?" The reply came back on the notepad, "Whatever it's worth, whatever its price." Let us go on to the next para. Ray reached into his cash box, pulled out a $50 note and passed it into the older man's hand. As they shook hands, as both Ray and the older man shook their hands, Ray looked into the man's eyes. They seemed to say, "Thank you." Ray noticed that the man's eyes, older man's eyes, they seemed looked to say, "Thank you." They both knew the watch wasn't worth that much. Both Ray and the older man, they both knew that the watch wasn't that much, means of $50. Before turning to leave, the man wrote, "I will be back to pick it up as soon as I can." What he mentioned in the notepad, "I will be back to pick it up as soon as early as possible. Merry Christmas. Happy Christmas." Let us move ahead to next and last para. The little story ended on the half hour with the clocks striking all together. What is mentioned here? The little story ended over completed in half an hour with the clocks striking all together. Almost all clocks striking means rang all together. Means there was a big wall clock and there was a pendulum in it. And it rings in every half an hour and 1 hour. So almost all clocks striking means rang all together. The timepieces, which had been looking on silently all the while, rang out the time with such feeling that even Ray thought he could hear them. The timepieces means clocks, watches, which had been looking on silently, which had been looking the incident on silently all the while, rang out time with such feeling that even Ray thought he could hear them. He could hear them. They means here clocks, watches. Their sweet musical message was filled with hope. There means here clocks, watches. Their sweet musical message was filled with hope. The timeless message of peace on earth, goodwill towards all, was filled by three men who stood in the old clock shop.